Good morning, my dear fifth class students. Let us start from the page number 8. I would like to tell something, that is, whenever you are going to add numbers, first you draw a tabular form where you have to mention the place values, that is, ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, lakhs, and 10 lakhs, like this. Then you start doing it. Because it is very important for you. When you go to the next class, you are going to have a numbers in the decimal forms, right? After decimal, the place value will be different. So you have to understand that. Because of that, you people should now practice each and every problem, especially the number system, in a tabular form. So here 4,1,062, right? So 4 is in lakhs place. So this is your lakhs place. I'll just change the color so that you can understand. 4 is in lakhs place. So 4 lakhs. This is your lakhs place. So remaining, I'll keep it all zeros. Okay. Everything. And then this is 1,000. The 1 is in thousands place. So this is your thousand. So you keep it 1 in the thousand place. Again, you keep all zeros in all other columns. And 62. So 62 means what? This is your ones place, this is your tens place. That is nothing but 60 and 2. So this is tens place, you write down 6. That is 6 becomes 60 and 2 is in ones place. Now you are going to add this. That is nothing but 2, 6, 0, 1, 0, 4. This is 0. No need to copy. So it becomes 4,1,062. This is your answer. 4,1,062 is your answer. Similarly, do the next one. 9,70,505. So 9 lakhs. So keep it in. I'll just change the color so that you can understand much better. So I'll just do it up. 9 lakhs. So I'll keep it. I'll draw the line and do it. This is your ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, lakh, and this is your 10 lakhs. So we'll come back again. 9 lakh. So this is your 9 lakh. Keep all zeros. Okay. And then 70,000. Okay. That is 10,000's place. Where you write down 70. Got 1,000. 500. Okay. So you write down in 100's place value 5. That is in 100 place value you write down 5. Right. And then only 5 is there, so you write down only 5. Now, what is the answer for this? You got 5. I'll write down here 5, 0, 5. When you total it, okay, 5, this is 5, 0, 5, 0, 7, 9. That is 9,70,505. So you write down here 9,70,505. Similarly, we can do the next one. Write the numbers in words. So how are you going to write these numbers into words? Okay, these numbers into words. I'll just rub this so that you can easily. Okay, we'll clear the place here first, then we'll go for it. For this is C. This also you please try to write down in right table so that you will come to know actually, right? So how are you going to do this problem? This problem is also very easy. That is, I'll just write down here 4, 3, 5, 6, 7, 2. So this is your ones place, this is your tens place, this is your hundred place, this is your thousand place, this is your 10,000 place, and this is your lakhs. So this is 435,672. So you write down here 435,672. So in this way you have to do it. Okay, then we'll go to do this one, the B one, by yourself and write, complete it. Let's see. Then identifying values of digits in the numbers within. Here you see how many numbers you have here. Ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, lakhs, and this is your 10 lakhs. Okay, so let's see. Now we will see it here on the page number 8. This is your 6, right? 3, 9, 1, 4, 2, 1. So here given the same value. 6 is in ones place, 3 is in tens place. So from this we can do this 3 required one. The digit 1 is in the lakh place and its value is, this is 1 is in 1 lakh place. Therefore you have to write down 1 into 1 lakh place. 1 into 1 lakh place, that is nothing but its value has become 1 lakh. Similarly, the digit dash is in thousands place. Thousands place is what? What is the number? 4. So number 4 is in thousands place and its value is what? 4 is in thousands place means what? 4 into 1000. That is nothing but its value is 4000. You understood? Similarly, let us do this. In, right, 345713, the digit dash is in the lakhs place. I am telling you again and again, students, every value, first you draw one rough, right, column like this, right, in a tabular form, and put this values in these columns, right, with respect to the place values, ones, tens, hundred, thousand, and 10,000, right, lakh, so on. Then only you'll get the correct value, and I want you to practice every value, right, by making a tabular form. Till then you please don't do it, otherwise I am not going to correct the papers also. So here orally I'll explain it, but you people do it in a tabular form, and you should not do, right, anything in the textbook. Everything you have to copy in the fair notes and you have to get to me for correction. So here it is ones place, tens place, ones place, tens place, hundred place, thousand place, 10,000 place, and this is your lakh place. 3 is in lakhs place. Therefore it is, its value will be number into the place value. Place value is how much? Lakh. So therefore this is lakh. So it gives answer as 3 lakhs. Similarly, in this figure, the digit 4 is in dash place. Digit 4. This, see, this is ones, tens, hundred, thousand, and this is your 10,000. So 4 is in 10,000 place. Sorry, 4 is in 10,000 place. 4 is in 10,000 place. So 10,000 place. So its value is how much? The number into its place value. Place value is how much? 10,000. So 10,000, that is 40,000. Similarly, now in this, right, you people already did this in your previous class. You have to add. See, the first one you get it draw a tabular form and then do it, then it becomes how much, right? 70,000. You get it as 70,000. Okay, 2,70,846. If you split it, you get the same value. Okay, right. Then we'll go to the comparing numbers within, right, 10 lakhs. Let's see. Compare this value. Okay, you please go through this, you'll come to know very easily. Then come to this. Compare, right, this value and these values, which is greater. First compare the lakhs, then we'll see. Okay, so for this also you please draw lines. This is like this, and then you try to compare it. Till then please don't do it. This is your 1's place, 10's place, 100th place, 1000th place, okay, 10,000th place. This is lakhs and this is your 10 lakhs. Now you first keep this figure 2,31,358. You keep it from the last. This is 1's place is 8. 1's place is 8. And then second one is 5,31,32. And now go to this one. Second figure. That also you keep it from the last. 8,35,312, and then you keep it even this value also here, that is the same numbers, the same place values, 5,7,3,1,3,2. Now how you are going to compare to get your highest and lowest value? So here first you compare the lakhs. Okay, if you are comparing with lakhs, what happens? All the three values are right in the lakhs, in 2 lakhs only. This is 2 lakhs, 2 lakhs, 2 lakhs. So now compare to the 10,000 lakhs. Now you see, here is first value you have 3 and third value you have 3. This is your 1 value. So this is your lowest value. Okay. So this is your lowest value, that is smallest value. But which is bigger out of these two? Because here also you have 3, here also you have 3. In such case, just go to the right next place value. And now you see here also this first value, here also third value are same, 1 and 1. You cannot find it out here. Then you go to this in the hundredth place value. So bad luck, in 100th place also you have 3. And also in right here you have 3. So you have same value. Now you just place it on, go to the next place value and find it out. Here you have 5, here you have 7. Now tell me which is greater. 7 is greater, right? So therefore this third value is greatest value out of these 3. So this is your first value, this is your second value, and this is your third value, last, lowest, smallest value. So he is asking you to write which is greater. So write down, this is greater, that is 2,31,375, this one, right? So 2,31,375 is your greatest value, and the smallest value is the last, that is, this is the middle value, is the smallest value, right? So therefore you write down 2,13,538. Now arrange the numbers in order from the greatest we have. So you have to write down the three values in these three blanks from arranging greatest side. That is, what is the greatest side? This is the greatest side I have mentioned here, right? So that is, you get it as 2,31,375. Second one is, this is the second one I told you. Okay. So that is 2,31,358. And third one, obviously this is your third one, that is 2,13,538. Got it? I'll give you more exercise problems, right, in a PDF form, not from the textbook, from but my right other books, so that it is useful for you people to practice it. Okay, right? Yes. Let's see. Here he has given one, right? 10 lakhs is nothing but, right, 10 lakhs. This is ones, tens, 100,000, 10,000 lakh, and this is 10 lakhs. So 10 lakh. 70 lakhs means what? 70 into how much? See here, that is, this is thousands, right? So how many? Slowly you are coming into international numbering system. That's why here he is making you, okay, 70 lakhs means how many thousands are there here, right? 10 lakhs is equal to, right, thousands. That is, here you have, see, thousand of thousands. Similarly here, how much it becomes? What? 70. Okay, 1,000 and 1,000. So here 10 lakhs means what? Thousands, thousands. So here 70 lakhs means what? You have to write down 70 of thousands. So the selling price of the house is 7 lakhs. Read 70 lakhs. So you have to read like this. But anyway, I don't think you people have understood here. But anyway, I'll just explain you in the next coming format. We'll do it. Okay, don't worry. Write the numbers 70,03,000. So here again I told you, okay, to draw first the tabular form. I'll explain one so that you people do it and I'll check it. Okay, this is your table, this is your ones place, this is tens place, this is 100 place, this is 1,000 place, this is 10,000 place, this is lakh place, and this is your, okay, 10 lakh place. So I'll just change the color to something bright. So here 70 lakhs. Okay, so 70 lakhs means you keep it all in, right, zeros, and then 3,000. So write down 3 in thousands place. So here 3 and this is 1,000. Now if you add it, you get it as, if you get it as 0,0,0,3,0,0,7. So this is the value 70,03,000. Similarly, you can do the next another two problems, that is 90 lakhs and 24 lakhs also you can do, but the condition is you have to draw, right, a table for it, place values, then you can do it. Even write the numbers in words, write the numbers in words also you have to do it in the tabular form. But anyway, I'll just give you one this one. So this is your ones place, tens place, 100,000, 10,000 lakhs, and this is 10 lakhs. 10, this value is at 10 lakhs. That is 4 into 10 is how much? 4. So 4 into 10 lakhs, that is nothing but how much? 40 lakhs. Therefore you write down this as, right, 40 lakhs. Okay, sorry, this is plus, this is one is also there, no? Okay, fine. I'll just delete it, right? I'll just delete it. That is 41 lakh, right? And 26,000. Similarly, do this, right? It becomes how much? This is your ones, tens, 100,000, 10,000 lakhs, and 10 lakhs. So 36 into 10, right? Okay, so 30 plus 6, 36. Okay, so 36 lakhs, that is 36 lakhs 90,000. Okay, 90,500 580. So in this way you have to do it, but until unless you draw in a tabular form, you are not going to understand, neither you are going to write, have a permanent system of learning. Then coming to this, the next one is, let's learn the same thing here. Okay, 3 of 10 lakhs means what? 3 of 10 lakhs means what? What is the value of this 3 into 10? 3 into 10 means 30, means 30 lakhs. Plus, this is 2 lakhs, 2 into 1 is 2 lakhs. So, 30 plus 2 is 32 lakhs. So, in that way you have to, so 32 lakhs, right, 87,263. So, here the digit in the 10 lakhs place is 3 and its value is 30 lakhs. Good. The digit in the lakh place is 2. Lakh place is 2. So, its value is 2 into 1 lakh. Okay. Is equal to how much? 2 lakhs. That's all. Its place value is, right, 2 and its value is 2 lakhs. Then the digit 8 stands for, the digit 8 stands for what? 10,000. So 8 into 10,000. That is nothing but 80,000. This, right? 8 stands for 80,000 then. Then coming to the next one, let's see. In this value, the digit in this value, right, the digit dash is in the lakhs place. So again check, ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, lakh, that is 5. So the digit 5 is in lakhs place, therefore its value is 5 into this lakh value, right, 5 into lakh value. So it becomes 5 lakhs. Similarly, in the digit, this one, the 4 is in dash place. Let us see what is 4. 1s, 10s, 100, 1000, 10,000, lakh, 10 lakhs. That is 4 is in 10 lakhs place. Is in 10 lakhs place. Therefore, its value is 4 into 10 lakhs. That is nothing but how much? 40 lakhs. Similarly, you have to go for this. See, this is your, right? This is your, if you add this value 10, this is ones, this is tens, this comes under hundreds, right? This comes under thousand, this comes under 10,000 and lakh, and this is your 20. Lakhs. If you do it in tables, definitely you are going to understand. Okay. Now, let's. There are about 1 crore vehicles in Delhi. 1 crore means how much? 100 lakhs. Okay. Remember, 1 crore is nothing but 100 lakhs. The number of vehicles about this one, read it as 1 crore. That is simply ones, tens, hundred, ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, lakh, 10 lakhs and crores. So in crores place, what is the value? 1. That's why it is called as 1 crore. Similarly, you can check it here. This is your, see here, given. This is your ones place. This is your, right, tens place. This is your hundredth place. Okay. Similarly, if you go on,
let's see, this is ones place, tens place, hundred place, thousands, lakh, 10 lakhs, crores. Ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, lakh, 10 lakhs, and this is your crore. So the answer is 2 crores. So here given 2 crores, 17 lakhs, 17 lakhs, 53,486. So you have to understand the value. Let us see here. Anyway, I'll stop this here. I'll explain again in the next video class the place values, and also right 10 lakhs place values, crore place values, and 10 crores place values. Meanwhile, you just practice it, look forward the video again and again. If you have any doubt, you just ping me through WhatsApp. I'm always there for you people, right? You're all my favorite students. So all the best to all of you. Have a nice day. Thank you. Good morning, my dear 5th class students. Especially Cherry and Likita were asking word problems doubt. So, especially in international numbering system. So, please kindly listen, because in this tutorial, in this video, you are going to come across these things. So, till last video, we have finished up to right page number 12. Now, we are going to from page number 13. So, write the numbers, that is 4 crores, 30 lakhs, 20,300. So, you have to draw a tabular form first, and then this is your Indian numbering system, we call it as, that is ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, lakh, 10 lakhs, crores, and 10 crores. This is your right Indian numbering system. In this, you write down first one is 4 crores, that is 4 you write down in crores place value, that is 4 here, right? Remaining you keep all zeros. And then 30 lakhs, that is 30 means what? 3 into 10. 10 lakhs place low, you write down 3. So 3 you write down in 10 lakhs place and keep all zeros. And then 20,000. Okay, 20,000, 2 into 10,000. Okay, so in place of 10,000, you write down 2. So in place of 10,000, I have written 2 here, and remaining all I kept 0. And 300, so I kept it 3 in 100 place, and then right zeros. Now you add all these things, it becomes 0, 0, 3, 0, 2, 0, 3, and 4. One thing is very important, Cherry and Likita, that in Indian numbering system, right, commas are actually in international numbering system and Indian numbering system, right, first point is about putting the commas, okay, between the numbers, putting the commas between the numbers. So in Indian numbering system, you have to keep commas from the right side. First comma you should keep after 3 digits, and then you have to keep commas after every 2 digits. Okay, remember, in Indian numbering system, from the right side, first comma you should keep after 3 digits, and afterwards you keep comma every right 2 digits. So this is the way Indian numbering system works. Now you see, this is your 4 lakhs, 4 crores, 30 lakhs, 20,300. So you write down here 4 crores, 30 lakhs, 20,300. In this way you have to do it. So this is your Indian numbering system, numbering system, first you should learn about the commas. So from the right side, first three digits before you keep it a comma, then for every two digits you have to keep a comma. This is your Indian numbering system. Then coming to the next one, also you can do it in the same way, right? That is 8 crores. Okay, I'll just keep it here 8 crores. I'll keep it here 8 crores. Okay, 19 lakhs, that is 19 lakhs. Okay, 12,000, right? 12,000. 201. Now you see, without doing in this, right, if you write down, see, comma is, now you study the comma. Comma is, first comma is before three digits, then you keep another comma after two digits, here after two digits, like now it is 8 crores, 19 lakhs, 12,201. In this way you have to do Indian numbering system. Similarly, now if you go to this one, this is your, see, you keep it this in the first table form. Okay, this is your ones place, this is your tens place, this is your hundred place, this is your thousand place, this is your 10,000 place, and this is your lakh place, this is your 10 lakhs place, and this is your crore place. As I told you, right, in Indian numbering system you have to keep commas, right? The first comma you have to keep before three digits from the right side. I'll keep it comma here, and then you have to keep comma in between every two digits, here and here. Now it becomes 9 crores. So you have to write down 9 crores, what, 16 lakhs. Okay, 16 lakhs, 80,000. Okay, 80,000 and 300. In this way you have to do it. Now see here, this is Indian system only, this number, because if you want to check, you can check. The comma, first comma is before three digits, next two commas are right in between of two digits. So this numbering system, you call it as Indian numbering system. Similarly here, this is also Indian numbering system only. The first comma is before three digits and next commas are before every two digits, right? So this is also Indian comma system. So this is your hundredth place, this is your thousandth place, this is your lakhs place, and this is your crore place. So this is 2 crores, right? 2,75,834. You please write down here, and then it's over. Then coming to the next, this is also the same. The only thing is, right, you have to write down, whenever you see the numbers, by just commas only you can easily identify whether it is an Indian numbering system or international numbering system. So here it is Indian numbering system only. The first three digits, then after every two digits there is a comma, right? So the digit 3 in the 10 lakhs place, and its value 10 lakhs place. So digit 3 is in 10 lakhs place. So 3 into 10 lakhs, how much? 3 into 10 lakhs, that is nothing but 30 lakhs. So its value is 30 lakhs. The digit 7 stands for ones, tens, hundred, thousand. Stands for thousand, that's all. He is not asking you to find the value, he is asking only the place where it stands. It's a thousandth place. It stands in thousandth place. Fine. Now coming to the next one. Fill in the blanks. This is Indian system or international system? Look first the number. It is Indian system only. You have comma, right? First before three digits, and then for every two digits you have a comma. So this is Indian numbering system. So this is your ones, tens, 100, 1000, 10,000, lakh, 10 lakhs and crores. Okay. So here we'll see. This is your ones. This is tens. This is 100. This is 1000. This is, right? This is 10,000. This is lakhs and this is crores like us. The digit dash is in 10 lakhs place. So, ones, tens, 100,000, 10,000, lakh, 10 lakhs. So, digit 10 lakhs place is 1. And its value is 1 into 10 lakhs. That is nothing but 10 lakhs that you write down as how much? 10 lakhs means ones, tens, 100,000, 10,000, lakh, 10 lakhs. Now you see, if I keep it zeros like this, then it becomes this one. This is your first, this is second, and this is your third. You understood now? So in this way, you have to do the next one also. It is very easy to do it. Now this is very important, right? That is comparing Indian and international system of numbers. Okay, so here Indian and international system number, it's very easy. I would like to explain. Okay, see, let's see. Indian system and international system, there is only one difference. Let me first clear this. I'll just show you. Right, I'll just draw two columns and I'll show you. I'll just draw two columns and I'll show you. This is one column and this is one column. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We'll go a little bit far. Okay, 9, 10. Let's see. This is your right Indian system, okay, Indian system, that is ones, tens, 100, 1000, 10,000, lakhs, 10 lakhs, crore and 10 crores, okay. In international system, this is ones, this is tens, this is 100, this is 1000, this is 10,000, this is 100,000, that is, you can write it down 100,000, okay, this is 1 million, this is 10 million, and this is 100 million, this is the difference here, okay. Now, if I give you one value, the value is like this. Example, if I give the value like 4 crores, right, 72 lakhs, 36,000, 927. If I give like this, or if I give 928. Okay, I'll even change this. I'll give you right 5 because different numbers are there. Different numbers should be there. So Indian system is what? First you have to understand, you can easily learn, right, how to tell the value by only keeping the commas. In Indian system, the commas, as I told you, the first comma you should keep it only before 3 digits, then after every 2 digits you keep it comma, okay. So then it becomes, this is your 100th place, this is your right 1000th place, this is your lakhs place, and this is your crore place. It means what? 4 crores, 72 lakhs, 36,958. Okay, the same number if I write down in international system, how you are going to write first and then how to pronounce it. 4, 7, 2, 3, 6, 9, 5, 8. Same number I have written. In international system, what happens? You have to keep comma for every 3 digits. In between every 3 digits. Not in Indian system, you keep first comma before 3 digits, then every comma you keep it in between 2 digits, right? But here in international system, in international system, you have to keep comma for every 3 digits starting from the right side. So first 3 digits comma, second 3 digits comma. Okay, so now if I make it this like this, right, in international system. Okay, this is your ones, this is your tens, this is your hundred, this is your thousand, this is your 10,000, this is your 100,000, this is your 1,000,000, this is your, right, what? 10,000,000. So you have to write down 10 means 4 into 10, that is 40,000,000, right? 723,000. Okay, so in this way you have to go through it. Okay, let's see, right? I'll explain here in the questions so that you can understand much better. So this is your value. First one we'll see. There are 7 lakh cars produced in a factory in a year. Express this in international system in words and numbers. Let's see here. I told you what should be the this 7 lakh you have to write down first. See, lakhs, crores, you will find only in Indian system. By the word lakh itself, you will come to know this is Indian system. There is no lakh and crores in international system. Okay, so 7 lakhs means what? 7 lakhs means you write down in lakhs place 7. Okay, all zeros. Ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, lakh. The same thing, if you read this, we can write it down, right, Indian system like this. In Indian system, right, how many zeros? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 zeros are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 zeros are there. So first zero you have to keep it before 3 digit, then after 2 digit you keep it. This is your Indian system. Okay, now international system, the same value, if I write down international system here, this is your ones, this is your tens, this is your hundred, this is your thousand, this is your 10,000, up to here it is same. Okay, then after 10,000, this is 100,000. After this it is 100,000, then it is 1,000,000, then it is 10,000,000, then it is, right, 100,000,000. This is the international system. Now you see, what is this? 7 is in which place? 100,000 place. Okay, so this number, same number, if I write down here, right, 5 zeros are there, right? Yes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. But in international system, you have to keep commas, not like Indian system. In international system, you keep comma for in between every 3 digits, right? So first 3 digits here, and this is your 3 digits. Okay, if any number comes after this, then you will get a comma here. Okay, so luckily you have only this number, so you have. So now you see, this is 700,000, so that's why it is 100,000. So right, this is 1, okay, and this 3 numbers, 700,000. So you have to write down in international system the number is like this, and you have to write as 700,000 is your international, right, number in words. Similarly, let's go to this 20,000,000. 20 million. 20 million means what? 2 into 10 million. So you have to write down 2 in 10 million column. Okay, this is 10 million column 2. Okay, right. So remaining you keep it all zeros. Now you see, you have to write down in, right, Indian system. Means what? Automatically it comes as 2 crores. This is Indian system. So you have to write down as 2 crores. Okay, that is nothing but 2. How many zeros? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is incomplete answer until unless you put commas in Indian system. So that's why the first comma is before 3 digits, then comma is after every 2 digits. Now it is 2 crores. So this is your answer in word, and this is the number, Indian number system. Then coming to the next one, I'll explain this. A toy factory made 2 crores, 14 lakhs, 70,300 toys in year. Write the amount in numbers and express it in words in international system. So first we will write down, okay, this number in Indian system. Okay, here we'll write down, this is your ones, Indian system, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, lakhs, 10 lakhs, crore, this is your 10 crores, okay, right. Now, the toy factory made 2 crores, 2 means 2 into 1 is 2, that is 2 crores, okay. Now, 14 lakhs, that is 14 lakhs, 70,000, 70,300. This is 300. Now you have written this in Indian system. Now you should make it international system. Same thing, but you write down the numbering values down here. Let's see. This is your ones. This is your tens. This is your hundred. This is your thousand. This is your 10,000. This is your what? 100,000, and this is your what? 100,000 afterwards, 1,000,000. After 1,000,000, it is 10,000,000. Now, so this is the value, you got it. See, just check once again, ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, 100,000, 1,000,000, 10,000,000, and this is your 100,000,000. Okay, right? Okay, fine. Now we'll write down this number. I'll write down the number here and we'll keep it commas according to international numbering system. That is 2 1 4 7 0 3 0 0. Okay, for every 3 digits you have to keep comma. Okay, in international numbering system, so this is your first 3 digit, keep comma. This is your second 3 digit comma. Then what is this here? 21 millions. So this you write down, this is your million. Okay, this is your million. This is your 100,000, and this is your only 100 value. So 21 million, okay, 470,000 and 300 is your international system. So 21 millions, 470,000 and 300 is the right number name. in international numbering system. Is it clear to you? Hope you people understood. Okay. And these things are all in what you call this page number, this page number 15, all in Indian system only, right? And you people are very good in doing it, so do it. And this is the thing, right? I'll do it on a ninth one, because here he has given, right, international system and all. Okay, this is the number. Okay, in Indian system is like this. So its place value, we'll see. It is giving only place value. It is not giving you the value of that number. Okay, so underline is 8. So 1, 10, 100 and 1000. This is thousands place. Now the same 8 here, let's see. In international system, 1s, 10s, 100 and 1000. This is also in international system, 1000 only. Then come to this one. Underline 2 is here. So 1s, 10s, 100, 1000, 10,000, lakh. Means what? Right? 20 what? Lakhs. 2 lakhs. Okay. This is, see, this is 1s, 10s, 100, 1000, 10,000, lakh, and this is 10 lakhs. Okay, so 2 is in lakhs. Now the same 2, we'll see in international numbering system. This is your 1s, 10s, 100, 1000, 10,000. This is 100,000. Okay, so 2 is in which place? 100,000. Okay, right. Similarly, let's go to this one. This one, 5 is underlined here. So 1, 10s, 100, 1000, 10,000, lakh. This is 10 lakhs. Means what? 5 into 10. That is 10 lakhs place. He has given not to, he is not asking you to value. You just write down, right? 10 lakhs place. That's all. Okay. Now here, see, okay, this is 1s, 10s, 100, 1000, 10,000, 100,000, after 100,000, 1 million. So this 5 is in 1 million. So write down 1 million. Is it clear? Right? I'll give you a lot of homework based on this after completing this topic. Definitely you people are going to do it. Okay, you are going to learn perfectly. So I can say you people, right, up to 17, if I finish it off, right, if you finish up to 17, then I think the work done. Okay, from 18 we'll start again in the next class, and I'll try to finish these three values. We'll definitely go for it. Thank you anyway. Stay happy and stay healthy. Good morning, my fifth class students. Let us do word problems. The first one is, the total number of female voters at a state election was this much. So how you are going to pronounce? First you write down clearly, that is right, 5, 9, 1, 9, 9, 8, 9. This is your 1s, 10s, 100, 1000, 10,000, lakhs and 10 lakhs. That is 59,19,989. This way you are going to pronounce. So these are female voters in a state election. The number of male voters are this much, 1s, 10s, 100, 1000, 10,000 lakhs and 10 lakhs. That is 73 lakhs. 73 lakhs and 89,000 are male voters. What was the total number of voters? So here you identify one word, keyword, that is total. So you have to add it. So how are you going to write down I'll just give you here. Solution. The total number of female voters, that is female voters, are how many? 59,19,989. This is given. Either you can write given in the last or you can write down in the beginning. No problem. Then male voters. Male voters are 73,89,000. Total number of voters is equal to how much? Means you have to add. Now I'll just draw a table. Based on that you have to go for it. Let me draw the table here. Say this is your ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, lakhs, and this is your 10 lakh. Fine. Now number of female voters, how much? 59 lakhs. 59,19,989. Similarly, male voters are how much? 73,89,000. So the total voters are how much? You have to add this. 9 plus 0 is 9. Similarly, 8, 9, 9 plus 9 is 18. Carry one here. 8 plus 2 is 10. Carry one here. 9 plus 1, 10 plus 3 is 13. This is 1. 7 plus 6 is 13. Okay. Now this is after 10 lakhs, it will be your crore. Okay, therefore it is 1 crore. So total voters are how many? 1 crore 33 lakh 8,989. In this way you are going to do the problems, word problems. So understand the keyword, whatever keyword given, based on that you have to do it. Am I clear? Right. Then go to the next problem. I'll just now come to the second problem. Mars has a diameter of 67,92,000 meters. Earth's diameter is 1 crore 27 lakhs. This is 1 crore 27,56,000 meters. What is the difference between their diameters? So here three things you have to understand. Number one is this Mars, Earth, they are planets. As you know, we have 8 planets. Out of 8 planets, Earth is also, one planet, and Mars is also another planet. This is what you have to understand. The second is you have to understand the diameter. Diameter means, suppose if this is a circle, then this distance is called its diameter, from this point to this point. So Earth diameter is bigger. You see, this is in crore, 1 crore. So this is your Mars and this is your Earth. Earth is a bigger one. It has a diameter from here to here is this much. What is the difference between their diameters? Now you see, you have understood two things. One is what is Mars, what is Earth, and other things. Second one is you have understood what is diameter. Now the third thing is, find out the keyword from this problem so that you can do it. The keyword is difference. Difference is what? Subtraction, as I told you in the keyword. So you have to subtract. So subtract is possible only from bigger number. You can subtract this smaller one. So write down the bigger number, then you subtract here. Before that, you have to write down the sentence given, that is Earth diameter and Mars diameter. The difference is Earth's diameter minus Mars diameter. Okay, Mars diameter. So that is, first you have to write down Earth's diameter. What is Earth's diameter? Earth's diameter is something 1 crore. See here, this is your ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, lakh, 10 lakhs, and this is crore. But here in the table we have only this much, so write down here also crore and then will 1,27,56,000 is the diameter of the Earth minus the diameter of the Mars is 67,92,000. We get it as 6 minus 2 is 4, right, 5, 9. So carry one number becomes 15. 15 minus 9 is your 6. And here is new number is 6. It is not possible to take one from here, it becomes 16. 16 minus 7 is your 9. And here the new number is 1. You carry this 1 here. So 11 minus 6 is your 5. That is 59,64,000. Therefore, the difference between their diameter is, you have to write down the difference between, you have to write down in full words because I'm writing in a very short form. So don't do that mistake. Okay, their diameter is how much? 59,64,000. This is meters. Here units given. Units given, meters. It is in meters. It is in meters. So that's why you get even in answer as meters. So this is the answer for the second question. Now go to the third one. The population of a country A is in 2005 was something like, you just see here, 1, 10, 100, 1000, 10,000 lakh, 10 lakhs and crores. That is 2 crores, 5 lakhs, 44,000 and 60. That is, I'll repeat the question again. The population of country A, there is a name of a country A. In 2005, in country A, the population was this much, 2 crores, 5 lakhs, 44,000 and 60. By 2015, it was 4 crores, 38 lakhs, 25,200. By how much did the population of country A increase in 10 years? By how much? So whenever you get by how much keyword in the question, you have to minus it from bigger number, right? You have to subtract a smaller number from bigger number. So we'll see. First we'll go with the statement given. The population in the, or you can say the population, please write down in a complete spelling. Don't write short form in your answer book. Given the population of country A in 2005 was how much? 2 crores, 5 lakhs, 44,000 and 60. In 2015, the population was how much? 4 crores, 38 lakhs, 25,200. So the increase in the population, therefore, the increase in the population was, the population, this one, that is 4 crores 38 lakhs 25,200 minus 2 crores 5 lakhs 44,060. So you have to do it here. The bigger value is this, so you write down this value. I'll just change the color and I'll write down, change the color and write down, that is your 4 crores 38 lakhs 25,200 minus 2 crores 5 lakhs 44,060. You have to subtract this 0. 10 minus 6 is 4, then the new number 1, 1 minus 0 is 1, this is 1, again you take one carry here, 12 minus 4 is 8, here is new number is 7, 7 minus 5 is 2, and this is 3 and this is 2. That is, you get it as 2,32,81,140. This much population has increased from 2005 to 2015. In this way you have to write down. Hope you have understood this. Let's go to the next page now. You can do all these things. Whenever you have additions, you keep addition. Whenever you have subtraction, keep subtraction. But every problem you do it in a tabular form by writing it, place values up like ones, tens, hundred and so on. It's a good practice, I'm telling you, and it is a correct way of practicing the problem. So don't time pass it just by doing it. Please do it in a tabular form. Then come to the next one. I'll do the word problems. Here it's a mixture of addition and subtraction. Solve the word problems. You may draw bar models to help you show your work clearly. So we don't draw bar models, because now you are in 5th class, tomorrow you are going into 6th class. Just try to solve problem by understanding it logically. Company A collected this much clothes at a charity drive. So here, this is your ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000 and lakhs. So Company A collected 5,53,078 clothes at a charity drive. Charity means voluntary, at a free of cost, danamu, what you call it. And Company B collected this much, 78,000 and more clothes than A. How many clothes did Company B collected? I'll explain in Telugu once, you can understand. Company A undi, inni battalu collect chesindi. Company B, deeni kante, Company A kante 78,021 ekko collect chesindi. So enta ekko collect chesindi ante manam em chestamu, will simply add these two, this one and this one. 5,53,078 plus 78,021, ee rendu add chesthe manaki Company B enta collect chesindi vachestundi. So first one meer em rastaru, given Company A collected how much? 5,53,078 clothes. Company B collected how much? 78,021 more clothes than Company A. Therefore, for total clothes collected by Company B is, you write down in a tabular form as I told you, then only you will get good, correct and accurate answer and clear understanding as well. Ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, lakh, and this is your 10 lakhs. So here only 5 lakhs there. So you add 5,53,078 clothes plus how much more collected? That is 78,021. You add this, then only you can get answer. That is 9,909,011,131. That is 6,31,099 clothes. So total clothes collected by Company B is how much? 6,31,099. So this way you have to do this. Okay. A property developer needs 3,76,39,523 bricks to build a township. It has 2,83,26,416 bricks now. How many more bricks must it buy? So, oka real estate property developer daggara, oka township, oka real estate venture develop cheyadaniki enni bricks kavali? 3,76,39,523 bricks kavali itkalu. కానీ అతని దగ్గర ఎన్ని ఉన్నాయి? ఓన్లీ 2,83,26,416 బ్రిక్స్. ఎన్ని బ్రిక్స్ ఇంకా కావాల్సి వస్తుంది అంటే టోటల్ బ్రిక్స్ ఎన్ని ఉన్నాయి కావాలో దాంట్లో నుంచి ఎన్ని బ్రిక్స్ ఉన్నాయో అది మైనస్ చేసేస్తే కావాల్సిన బ్రిక్స్ మనకి వస్తుంది. సో దీనికి హౌ యు ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు స్టార్ట్ సొల్యూషన్? గివెన్ టోటల్ బ్రిక్స్ required, how much? 3,76,39,523 bricks he has is how much? 2,83,26,416. The bricks he require is, you just minus it here, but you do it in a tabular form in your class workbook. So this is 13 minus 6 is 7, right? 1 minus 1 is 0, 5 minus 4 is 1, 9 minus 6 is 3, 3 minus 2 is 1, 6 minus 3 is 3, 17 minus 8 is 9. So how much he requires? See, 2 minus 2 is 0, so no need to write down. Total bricks he required, he requires is how much? 100, 1000, 10,000, lakhs and 10 lakhs. So how you are going to write down this? You are going to write down 93,13,107 bricks. అదే నేను స్టార్టింగ్ ఇక్కడనే ముందు టేబుల్లో రాసేసి పైన వన్స్ టెన్స్ రాసి ఉండి ఉంటే ఐ వుడ్ హ్యావ్ రైట్ ఎక్స్ప్లెయిన్ యూ వెరీ స్ట్రైట్ అండ్ క్లియర్ హౌ టు ప్రొనౌన్స్ ఇట్, బట్ ఐ హ్యావ్ డన్ ఇట్ డైరెక్ట్లీ. సీ, దిస్ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ మిస్టేక్స్ గోస్ ఆఫ్. సో ఎనీవే, కమ్ టు ది, యూ ట్రై టు డూ ది ఫిఫ్త్ వన్ ఆల్సో, లెట్ సి. కమింగ్ టు నెక్స్ట్ వన్, అప్రాక్సిమేషన్ అండ్ ఎస్టిమేషన్. దిస్ ఇస్ సంథింగ్ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్, అప్రాక్సిమేషన్ అండ్ ఎస్టిమేషన్. What do you mean by approximation and estimation? Let us study this. This video is going to be a little bit lengthy because I want to explain what is approximation and estimation. Approximation first I will explain you. Approximation is nothing but you are going to take the values. Approximation means dadapu, that is called approximation, approximately intaitadi. So here we are going to estimate it first and then we are going to consider its approximation. Fine. In this you have to understand three things. How you are going to estimate it? First we will take estimation, right? Estimation to the nearest one's value, right? Nearest to the one's value. Second one is we will take it approximately, that is nearest to the tens value, and approximation nearly, estimation nearly to the thousands value. So you have studied taking estimation to the nearest one's value in your fourth class standard, but even then I'll explain. Suppose if I give you the number, I'll write down here, it is, I'll take this example, 4,865. If I take it, right, estimation you should take it by rounding numbers nearest to its values. So we'll take first rounding the values on a ones place. Ones place here is 5. So here is 5. It's nearest rounding value. Rounding value means either it should be a starting value, that is 1, 5 and this is 10. 5 is in the middle, So you can take the approximation to the higher end. So rounding off value, if you take it 10, then it becomes 4865. No, here you'll take nearest value, that is 0, then it becomes 4865 plus another 5, you add it, it becomes 70. So this is your ones place value. If you take rounding off to the tens place value, then it becomes 4865. Tens place value, this one. So it becomes 6. 6 badalu manam em teeskuntamo, we'll take it one more value as 7. That is your estimation of your tens place, that is 4870. Suppose if you take hundreds value, then this 870 is nearer to 900. Therefore, you should take it as 4900. And if it is, you are taking estimation rounding value to the thousands place, then this 4900 is nearest to 5000. So you should take round value as 5000. This is what your rounding off value. So ones place unte manam only ones place value round off cheskovali. Tens place unte you should round off to the this 65, you should round it off. Then if you want to take hundreds round off value, then 865 is nearer to 900, so we'll take it 900. And if it is in thousands place, then 4900 is nearest to 5000. So in this way you have to take it. Suppose if you have 1, this is 5 and this is 10. If you get any value more than 5, say 6, 7, 8, 9, anywhere in between, the nearest value is this. If it is less than 5, say this is 2, 3, 4, if it is in between these values, then you have to take the nearest value is this. You got my point? So in this way you have to find, you have to first get the estimation value, and then you have to consider its approximation. So we'll see in this. This is round each number to the nearest thousand value. Thousand value. See here, 23,490. So 23,490 is nearest value of 1000 is 23,500. So you should write down 23,500. This is your approximation symbol. Approximation symbol antamu dinni. This is approximately this much. Similarly, this is nearest value is this only. Though it has increased to 50 more, but it is nearer to this. This is very far, okay, and this is also very far. So you take the nearest value. Round figure is how much? 54,500 itself is its estimation round value of nearest 1000. Here this is the nearest value for this, that is 39,900. The nearest value is 40,000. So you write down here as 40,000. Similarly, in the lakhs and crores also, in the lakhs and crores, so this value is nearer to, it's a, you have to find 10,000's nearest value. This is ones, tens, hundred, thousand and 10,000. Means you have to consider only this 48,000. 48,000. 48,360 is nearer to 10,000 value. It is nearer to 50,000. Yes or no? That's why you should take 2,48,360. Nearest value is 2,50,000. Similarly, you can do these problems. The nearest value for this one is, see here, this is 13,26,450. The digit 2 is in 10,000's place, the round value. So this is in 10,000's place, 26,000. So 26,450, this value is nearest to 26,500. The nearest value is 13,26,450. 500 is your nearest value. Nearest value in that 10,000. Fine. Similarly, do this. Even you can do this. Okay. Round off value to the nearest. It's a 10,000 value. 10,000 value manam deentlo choose them. This is 1, 10, 100, 1000 and 10,000 value. So this is 56,780. 56,780 is nearer to 60,000. That's why you write down 2,34,60,000. You made nearest 1,000 value, 10,000 value, and then lakh. We'll check the lakh number here in this. The same question you find it out lakhs. That is 2. I'll write down here 2,34,56,780. Now we'll consider it's lakhs. We'll round off the lakhs value. So find it out which is the lakh value here. This is ones, tens, hundred, thousand, 10,000, lakh. That is 4,56,700. And so it has increased above 50. That's why you take as, instead of 4,56,000, you take it as 5 lakhs. 2,35,00,000. That's all. That is nearest round value. 10 lakhs. You take 10 lakhs here. So this is 1, 10, 100, 1000, 10,000, lakh, and this is 10 lakhs. 10 lakhs means what? 34 lakhs. So it comes nearly to 35 lakhs only. So you write down the same thing here. 2 crores. This is your 34. So you write down 35 lakhs. No problem. 35 lakhs. Similarly, crore. 2,34,00,000. This is your crore value. 34 lakhs. So ivanni zeros chesandi. Simple. 2,34,00,000 is nearly 2 crores, but not 3 crores. 3 crores is very far from 2,34,00,000. That's why you just round it off as 2 crores. In this way you have to do it. So you can do addition, subtraction, everything from it. You can finish it off this. Multiplication also you can do it. Division also you can do it. Estimation values, because you did it all in your previous class. So I don't think you find any difficulties from this. Estimation another problem. I'll just take this factors and multiples in your next video, because it has now crossed more than half an hour. Thank you, and stay happy, stay healthy. Good day. Good morning, my fifth class students. As I told you, I'm going to explain factors and multiples in this video. But I have explained in very detailed way factors and multiples in another video. If you want, you can go in YouTube. You type in your search bar MathMen 4M27. If you type this in your YouTube search bar, MathMen 14, that is Roman M27, you will come to know the basics of factors and multiples. Actually, this video I have uploaded for class 4th standard. You can easily learn from this video. Let us come back to this one. Anyhow, I'll just repeat and read it here. The factors of 12 are 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 and 12. Let us see what are the factors you have. Example for 12. 1. 12s are 12. In 2 table, right, 12 goes. 2 6s are 12. Then in 3 table, 3 4 times 12. In 4 tables, 4 3s are 12. 5 table it won't go. 6 table it will go. 6 2s are 12. In 7 it won't go. 8 it won't go. 9 it won't go. 10 table you can't. 11 also no. 12, of course, you can go 12 one time, 12. These are the factors. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 and 12. This is what given here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 and 12 are the factors. It is a composite number. What do you mean by composite number? Means when you get more than two factors to a particular number, then that number you call it as composite number. So here 12, you have more than two factors. See how many factors are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 factors are there. So it is more than two factors. That's why 12 you call it as composite number. So in this composite numbers, you have to find what are the prime factors. Let's see, prime factors are nothing but prime numbers. Now you see, you have, suppose if I go with 2 into 6, 2 6 are 12, so 2 into 6, again we can go as 2 into 3, 2 2s are 4, 4 3s are 12. So here 2 and 3 are, you call it as prime factor. 2 and 3 are called prime factors. When we write a number as a product of its prime factor, then it is called prime factorization. That is, 2 into 3 is your 6. You understood now? Then coming to this is a tree method, I have already explained in your third standard. Factor by tree method. Suppose if you take down 36 number, if you factorize it, it goes into 2 into 18 times. 2 18s are 36. So you just copy the 2 as it is, and then this 18 can be written as 2 into 9. 2 9 times 18. So you copy 2, copy 3, and this 9, it won't go in 2 tables, so go in 3 table. 3 3s are 9. 2 into 2 into 3 into 3. Here he has given right explanation. You try to read it. You have to start with the smallest prime factor. So 2 is your smallest prime factor. 3 is your smallest prime factor. First you start with 2. If that number won't come in 2 table, then you go to 3 table. What we have done it here. So therefore the prime factor of 36 are 2 and 3. It goes into 2 and as well as into 3. They are called prime factors. Division method also. If you go into the division method, the same thing. See here, 36, when go with the minimum smallest prime factor 2, 2 1s are 2, carry 1, 2 8s are 16. So again you go with 2, 2 9 times 18, this 18. 18 won't go again with 2, so go with 3, 3 9s are, 3 3s are 9. Therefore, see 2, 2, 3, 3, the same thing, 2, 2, 3, 3. This is division method. The prime factors of 36 are 2 and 3. So here, if you want, you can write the prime factorization of each of the following numbers. Use factor tree method to find the answer and the division method to check your answer. Let's see, this is 60. Start with the smallest prime factor, that is 2. How much? 30s. And then this 2, 30, same you copy 2 again, and this 30 you cannot go, of course you can go in 2 tables, this one, 2, how much? 15s are 30. You copy this minimum 2 prime factors, then this 15, 3, 5s are 15. So 2, 2, 3 and 5. So you have 2, 3 and 5 are prime factors for this. 2, 3, 5 are the prime factors. Similarly, you do to 210. In the division method also you can do it. Now you see, if I take 75 can be divided by 5 exactly. 5 is a factor of 75. 80 is also exactly divisible by 5. Okay, see here, if I divide 75 with 5, what happens? 75 with 5, you will get 0 remainder. 5 1s are 5, 25. 5 5s are 25. 5 is exactly divisible to 75. Therefore, 5 is, you call it as factor of 75. Similarly, 80 you can divide by 5. It goes exactly. 5 ones are 5, 3. 30. 5 6 are 30. So, remainder is 0. 5 is a factor because it is exactly divisible. So, 5 is a factor for 80 and also 5 is a factor for 75. 5 is a factor of both 75 and 80. 5 is a common factor because it is a factor for 75 as well as it is factor for 80. The number which you get common in the both values, then you call that number as a common factor. Similarly, you just check it here. 4 is a common factor because 96, when you divide with 4, you will get remainder 0. For 84, when you divide with 4, you get remainder as 0. For 78, when you divide by 4, you get as 2. So, here 4 is common factor for 96 and 84, but not 78 because 2 is a remainder here, but whereas here exactly divisible, you got 0. 4 is not a common factor. No, 4 is not a common factor of 96, 84, 78. Out of these three numbers, for these three numbers, 4 is not a common factor, but whereas common factor for these two. Let's go to the next topic. Find out these things, it's very easy. We'll see now, finding common factors and greatest common factor. This is something important, greatest common factor, GCF, and least common multiple, LCM. These two are very important for you people. Just go for it. Let's see. If you take 30 number and 42 number, let's go. Right? In one table, 130 times 30. In two tables, 215 times 30. In three tables, 10 times 30. Four table, it won't go. Then go to five. In five table, 56 times 30. So, the factors of 30 are 1, 2, 3, 5 and 6. Similarly, go to this one. That is 1 into 42 is 42, 2, 21 times 42, 3, 14 times 42, 4 table it won't go, 5 table it won't go, 6 table it will go, 6, 7 times 42. So, the factors are this, 1, 2, 3, 6, 7 also it goes. 8 also it goes, 7 also it goes. Now, you can go with this one, 7, 14, 21 and 42 are also a factors for this. But let us just write down these factors. For this you have the factors 1, 2, 3 and 5. And for this you have the factors, I'll just change the color of it so that you can understand. For 42, you have the factors 1, 2, 3, 6 minimum. Okay. What are the factors here? Now, for 30, the factors are 1, 2, 3, 5, 6. And for 42, the factors are 1, 2, 3 and 6. Now, you just check it. What are the common here? This is common. This is common. This is common and this is common. The common are 1, 2, 3 and 6 are the common, right? So, the common factors are 1, 2, 3 and 6. 1, 2, 3 and 6 are common factors of both numbers 30 and 42. What is the greatest number out of this common factor? 6 is the greatest. Therefore, that is highest common factor, HCF, GCF and HCF, both are same. This HCF of 30 and 42 is 6. Similarly, you can find out for 40, 60 and 200. Fine. Now see, find the common factors and greatest common factor. You have to find out here two things. One is common factors. Second one is out of common factors. Right, greatest common factor we have to find. So, 1 into 50 is 50, 2 into 25 is 50, and then 5 into 10 is also 50. You understood? Similarly, 1 times of 40 is 40. In 2 table it goes 20 times, 2 20s are 40. In 4 time 4 table it goes 4 tens are 40. And then here it goes 8 5s are 40. Let's see. Here you have factors are this 1, 2, 5, 10, 25 and 50. 1, 2, 5, 10, 25, 50 are the factors for this. And here you have the factors for this is 1, 2, 4, 8, 5, 10, 20, 40. These are the factors. So the common factors of 50 and 40. Now you see what are the common out of this and these values. I'll just write down this here with another color. 1, 2, 5, 10, 25, 50. What are the common factors for this? 1 is common, 2 is common, 5 is common, and you have 10 is common. Right? Yes. And the greatest common factor, what is the greatest common? Among the common factor, you have to take the greatest common. So 10 is your greatest value. So write down 10 here. In this way, you can do to all these problems, and you finish it off doing this. Find common multiples now. We have checked their factors, common factors. Now let us check common multiples. And then we'll find out least common multiples. Let's see. If you take number 4, how many multiples you are going to get? See, there are infinite multiples, I'm telling you. Factors are finite, limited, but multiples are infinite, endless. If you take 4 in one table, right, 4, 1, 1 into 4 is 4. Here he has given 1 into 4 is 4. 2 into 4 is 8, 3 into 4 is 12, 4 4s are 16, 4 5 4s are 20, 6 4s are 24. If you take right this 4 and you start multiplying with tables, 1 table, 2 table, 3 table, 4 table, 5 table, 6 table, 7 table, 8 table and 9 table. The multiples of 4 are, what do you get? 4, 8, 12, so on, all the numbers. Fine. So the multiples of 4, nothing but you just go with the table. 4 1s are 4, 4 2s are 8, 4 3 are 12, 4 4 16, 4 5 20, 4 6 24, 4 7 28, 4 8 32, 4 9s are 36, 4 10s are 40, 4 11s are 44, right? 4 12s are also like this. You can go endless. Similarly, now you see if you take multiples of 6, you just repeat 6 tables, 6 1s are 6, 6 2s are 12, 6 3s are 18, 6 4 24, 6 5 36, 6 36, like that. We will take 1 is 4, another 1 is 6. What are the common multiples of 4? Common multiples of 4 are 4, 8, 12, 16, so on. What are the common multiples of 6? You have 6, 12, 18, so on. Now out of these two, what is the common multiple? What is the least common multiple? Ati takwa takwa plus common. Ikkada 6 undi, you don't have 6 here. Here you have 4, here you don't have 4. But you have only 1 is 12. Ati takwa value is 12. Therefore, the least means ati takwa. Least common multiple is how much? 12. For what numbers? For 4 and 6. So the next two common multiples of 4 and 6 are what? You have 12. Okay. You have 12 and 24 also common here. So you can write in down 12 and 24. So out of 12 and 24, which is the least? 12 is the least. So you will call 12 as LCM. So 12 is LCM of numbers 4 and 6. You understood? That is called least common multiple. So that you can do it. What is the least common multiple of these two? So first you find out 20 and 30. You just go with 20. Start with one table. We'll see. I'll just do it again here with one table to 20. If I go with 20, 1 into 20, 20, 2 into 10, 20, 3 it won't go, 4 it will go, 4, 5 times, 20, 6 it won't go, 7 it won't go, 5 it will go, 5 fours are 20. Similarly, it endless it goes. I'll just take it 4 values, let's see. And again, I'll take 30. I'll take 30 and I'll 1 into 30 is 30. And 2 into 15 is equal to 30. 3 into 10 is equal to 30. 4 it won't go. 5, 6 times 30. 6, 5 times 30. 7 it won't go, 8 it won't go, 9 it won't go, 10 it will go, 10 threes are 30. It will endless. So let us take these values 1, 2, 4, 5. Okay. 1, 2, 4, 5. And this will take it. What is that? I'll change the color so that you can. That is 1. 2, 3, 5, 6, 10. So there are so many numbers. Common. The common are 2, 4 you don't have, 5 you have. 5 you have. So 2, 5. So 2, and this is a common multiple. That is 2, 5. You should multiply to this. 2 into 5. 2, 5 is a 10. You understood? So this is your least common multiple for 20. You can do this. It is very easy. The first 10 multiples of 3 are, 10 multiples of 3 are, that is 3, 1 is a 3, 3 2 is a 6, 3 3 is a 9, 3 4 is a 12, 3 5 is a 15, 3 6 is a 18, 3 7 is a 21, 3 8 is a 24, 3 9 is a 27, and 3 10 is a 30. Similarly, 5 multiples you can do. The first 2 common multiples of 3 and 5 are 3 and 5 only, because 3 goes in 3 table, 5 goes in 5 table. In 3 table you won't get 5, in 5 table you won't get the 3. That's why the least common multiple of 3 and 5 is, you have to multiply, as I told you in the beginning, 3 5 times 15. So 15 is your least common multiple. Similarly, you can do the other problems also, and these are some divisibility rules. Divisibility rules, I have already given the worksheet in your previous class. But anyhow, if you want, you can check it here. Divisibility, a number is divisible by 3 if the sum of its digits is divisible by 3. Suppose, ikkadundi, if 75, whether this 75 is divisible by 3 or not, means you have to first add these two numbers, 7 and 5. 7 plus 5 is how much? 12. Now you check this 12 is divisible by 3 or not. Means in 3 table you get it 12 or not. Yes, of course. Yes, 3 fourths are 12. That's why 75 is divisible by 3. To know whether a given number is divisible by 3 or not, for that you have to add that sequence number and you check whether it is divisible by 3 or not. Similarly, if you go with 9 also, for 9 also you have to add all the numbers and then check the resultant number whether it is divisible by 9 or not. So this the rule for 3 and 9 number is same. For 4, right? Otherwise, we'll just check it here. Which of the following is right? It is useful for your practice purpose. Which of the following numbers is divisible by 3? 3 tone ee number divisible aitada idu aitada idu aitada idu aitada ante we have to, what is the rule there? You have to add and check, that is 1 plus 0 plus 8. 1 plus 0 is 1, 1 plus 8 is 9. In 3 table 9 goes off very easily, therefore this is right divisible. Okay, this is divisible. Now 574 divisible avutunda kada, you have to add 5 plus 7 plus 4. Let's see, 5 plus 7 is 12, 12 plus 4 is 16. 16, is it going to divide by 3? No, because 16 number you won't get in 3 table. That's why 574 is not divisible by 3. Similarly, check this number 2079. You please add these numbers. 2 plus 0 is 2, 2 plus 7 9, 9 plus 9 18. This 18 easily divisible by 3. 3 6 is 18. Yes or no? Yes. That's why 2079 is divisible by 3. So you please go through the rules of all the numbers 3, 4, 7, all the numbers, and then complete this exercise. And this also, it's very easy. By this, we have finished your chapter number 1. I'll give worksheets, homework worksheets, different problems from page number 1 to page number 33. As in the form of homework, you have to do it daily and just show me through WhatsApp. Thank you. All the best. We have finished today first chapter. Hope you are going to do the homework worksheets from tomorrow onwards. Stay healthy, stay happy. Bye.